Hi, I'm Barend from Tameson, and today we're going to talk about condensate drain valves. Air always contains moisture. When air is compressed, the amount of water per liter increases, leading to condensation. This condensed moisture must be disposed of. This moisture can stay in various parts of your compressed air system due to the pressure and temperature changes. This condensation can result in corrosion, increased wear due to reduced lubrication, grouping of dirt particles, and other damage to pneumatic equipment if the condensate is not effectively removed. To prevent accumulation of condensate in your system, a condensate drain is installed at the lowest point where condensate tends to gather, such as the air tank, filters, or dead ends in your piping. In principle, you can just take a simple manual valve to drain condensate, but in most cases, we recommend an automatic condensate drain. Manual draining is often forgotten, done infrequently, or done incorrectly where compressed air is released or not enough condensate is drained. Automatic condensate drains come in different types. First, a solenoid valve with an electric timer. You can set interval times and the opening time for the valve. They are easy to install, cost-effective, and reliable. However, the drawback is that if you open it too short, it won't drain all the condensate. And if you open it too long, it will let out compressed air. Second, an electronic level controlled condensate drain. They have an electronic sensor that monitors the condensate level. When it hits an upper limit, it opens and lets the condensate out of the solenoid valve. When the level goes back down, it senses this and closes the valve until the condensate level rises again. Therefore, there's no loss of compressed air. However, they tend to be more expensive than other options. The third type of an automatic condensate drain is a float-operated system. They use a float that automatically operates the condensate drain process by opening and closing the valve, typically through a lever mechanism. This allows them to operate with no power and have no loss of compressed air. FRL units, filter regulator lubricator units, also function as condensate drain in your compressed air circuit. Often you have the choice between manual, semi-automatic, or fully automatic condensate drainage. In semi-automatic drains, the valve opens every time the system is depressurized. Fully automatic drains typically make use of the float-operated system and drain automatically as soon as the condensate reservoir is full. For more information on condensate drain valve types, please read our technical article. Now let's select the right condensate drain valve for your application. For a simple, cost-effective solution, a solenoid valve on a timer is a good option. However, for a more advanced solution, one with a sensor can be used. If you have no power available, a float-operated condensate drain valve should be used. If power is available, an electronic level control drain is more effective. The condensate drain should be sized based on the max compressor capacity and if it contains oil or not. Now that you have a better understanding of condensate drains and how to select the right one, let's head over to Tameson.com to check out our extensive range of high-quality condensate drains. If you have any more questions about condensate drain valves or another product, please contact me or anyone else at Tameson. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for more valuable information on fluid control solutions.